Welcome back. Now, Young, Famous, and African is a Netflix original, first African reality television series following a group of glitzy and affluent media personalities from across the continent, all kings and queens of their field. These jet setters see their relationships tested as new cast members crash the party. Now, Bonang Matheba, Fantana, and our very own Louis Munana is set to join season two. And when we come back after this short trailer, Louis is here to tell us all about it.
Hey, hey, pardon my arrogance. Pardon my arrogance, that's how it go when I'm back in my element. Shaking the dust off, I'm just warming up where I haven't yet settled it. Pardon my arrogance. That's a double entendre. I got play money, I'm a monster. That's a competing at Gonka. Y'all are left feet to my salsa. Put all the blame on my melanin. Ladies and gentlemen, hold your applause, I am well away.
I am Bonang Matheba, an all-round badass Tswana girl. Okay.
Pardon my arrogance.
Well, 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 that's definitely something we don't want to miss. Louis, before we get into the nitty and gritty of, you know, your achievements and what you're busy with, I really have to take my hat off to you. You are the epitome of what I consider to be a mover and shaker. So first of all, congratulations.
Thank you.
On being cast for season two of Young, Rich and Young, Famous and African. Mm. How did you get selected for season two? Let's start there.
Honestly, I was minding my business, going about my day, and then I got a DM from one of the producers saying that they are looking to cast new members on the show. So because it's Instagram, I thought it was a joke, I ignored it. And then I got a phone call, I ignored it, I thought it was someone pranking me, and then I got an email. Then I was like, okay, maybe there's truth to this. I did my research and I saw that these are actually legit people, you know, and then I said, yes, why not? And
fantastic.
The rest is history.
The rest is history. Yeah. And how long did it take to shoot season two?
We filmed for about 3-4 months. Yeah, so I was living out of the country for 4 months. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Fantastic. And that was all in South Africa?
All in South Africa, yeah.
What was it like rubbing shoulders, you know, with you know, some of Africa's biggest celebrity personalities? Talk to us about that experience.
Big egos. Everybody feels they are the alpha in the room. Everybody feels they are the king or the queens, although everybody has achieved. So it's a lot of watch what you say before you start, like before you spark something. Everybody is, I made it, I'm here. Yeah. Look at me, bow down. And of course, you won't have that because I'm a king too, you know. So, yeah.
There was a snippet of one of the scenes, I suppose, that will come up in one of the episodes between you and Bonang, and there seemed to be a bit of drama or what's going on there? What's happening there?
Well, you would have to watch the show. But yeah, I mean, the scene isn't self-explanatory in a way, but there was a bit of friction between myself and her. So I honestly can't go into detail about what really happened because of NDAs and all of that.
Yeah,
but yeah, we clashed a little bit.
You're good now? Can't say?
I can't say either.
there's yeah. a lot of times people watch reality you know, shows and,
yeah.
and they're of the opinion that a lot of it is scripted.
Is it
the case here?
Well, in this case, it's not scripted. If let me explain the process. It's basically, for example, if you're on the show, so I'm on the show, someone invites me out for lunch, for example, and I meet someone that I don't know. So we interact, and if we hit it off, the producers will ask, do you want to film with them again?
Oh, right.
Yeah, so the episodes write themselves based on what happened in the previous episode. Mm-hmm. So, for example, if I see someone hot and I like them, I would ask the producers, I would like to, you know,
And go did out you on a date. See someone hot that you liked and would want to go out on a date? Because a lot of Young, Famous and African in season one, yeah. the focus around the characters, a lot of it was around their relationships, their yeah. personal relationships. Yeah. So with their baby daddies and baby yeah. mamas, you know, with yeah. fiancés and so on. Yeah. So
I mean, Nina, look at me. Who would not want a piece of this hot chocolate man? I mean, come on. So of course, there was, yeah, you know, like... Yeah. I'm not going to go somewhere for 4 months and not do something. I mean, come on. Come on.
That's yeah. a good and diplomatic answer. 2023 really seems to be your year, Louis. And you always seem to be on top of your game. I mean, yeah. when it comes to brands, you know, you're the first to come to mind in terms of the Namibian scene. And you're doing amazing.
Thank you.
You've just recently also launched your MCC brand with Zulu Boy. And that happened yeah. on Saturday,
on
wasn't
Saturday,
it?
On Saturday, yeah.
Called Razul.
Yes, yes. Yes,
talk
yes.
to us about that.
Well, we're so used to being brand ambassadors, influencers for other brands. So myself and Zulu thought to ourselves, we need to own something. We want ownership because we don't know how long this entertainment life is going to last.
Right.
There are people coming up every day. There are new ones, like youngins and so forth. So what about our kids? What about our legacy? Because we can't just make brands money. What about us? So we decided to venture into alcohol because what is that one thing that Namibians love to consume so much? Alcohol. So,
right.
Yeah. So, and my brand is very luxurious. I'm all about luxury. So the best thing that came to mind was an MCC, mm-hmm. a champagne. Of course, it's been 5-6 years of back and forthing and mastering the taste, the look, the feel, you know, just bypassing laws and all of that. And finally on Saturday, we launched it.
And what does the name Razul mean? What's the meaning behind that?
It means ownership and power.
And what yes. language?
We named it ourselves. We made it up ourselves.
Fantastic. I love that.
Yes.
That's awesome.
Thank
I want to talk about, you know, the logistics and the manufacturing process of something mm. like this. And you just mentioned it took about 5-6 years to yeah. take it from ideation stage, you know, up until it became a reality. Mm-hmm. So just briefly talk me through that process.
Well, first of all, the day you pick grapes from a vineyard, by the time you squeeze the juice out of it and put it into a barrel for it to start to ferment, for it to become alcohol and so forth, in order for it to be something that you can call a vintage, it needs to mature at least for 4 years. Mm-hmm. It's either you go the vintage route, which is now your fine, premium, expensive MCC or your wine or your champagne, you know. But if you want something that is fast, you can get it within a year, but the turnaround period is always 12 months. I mean, yeah, 12 months, which is a year. So from the time you pick your grapes, which is usually in January until December, that's the period that you can have a wine. But then we wanted a premium vintage sparkling wine, which is done in your MCC format, which is your Method Cab Classic. Mm-hmm. That means they have to go through a degorgement process whereby they take the juice and they put it inside the bottle and they cap it with your, you know, your Coke caps.
Right.
And then
right.
you have to remove that, take the sediments from the bottom, and you have to do the process in water before you put the cork in and before you put the wirewood in and all of that. So that degorgement process is something that also prolongs the whole champagne making process. So there are different methods of doing it, which determines the value of your wine and the quality. Yes, that also determines the price.
And of course, you're going to go there.
Of course, 4 years.
The
come
4-5 year route.
Minimum, yeah, of course.
Listen, hashtag yeah. boys with vineyards. Congratulations, it's a big, big, big achievement.
Yeah.
What else is in store for you for the rest of the year? I mean, it's only yes. May.
I don't know. I'm tired. maybe not. Something might drop soon. You never know. But for now, we're going to cruise on Young, Famous and African. We're going to cruise pushing Razul out there. I mean, I think I've done enough for the year. We're going to push on the Bwaka Kids Choice Awards, Standard Bank. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, for
busy,
now.
Busy, man.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Well, thank you so much for taking time out of your clearly busy schedule to be here this evening. And all
you.
The best with your future endeavors.
Arigato. Thank you so much.
That was Louis Munana speaking to us this evening about his recent casting in season 2 of Young, Famous and African, about his new MCC called Razul. If you want to keep up with him, I suggest you follow him on his socials and see what's happening next.